And we're back. Thanks for a great song.
Thank you.
You're all based here in Ottawa, I'm assuming. Are you all from Ottawa originally?
Well, I was born in Ottawa here. You?
Yeah. I'm from Petawawa, actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so a little distance away. But I know you've been in town a long time.
I've been here since the 90s.
Yeah. Which 90? I was curious.
I moved 96. I moved here.
I came a year later. I was 90, okay.
Steve, our bass player, Steve's been in Ottawa forever, as far as I know. And our drummer, Ernie, is actually a more recent addition. He moved here about 5 years ago.
Okay.
And
this is punk rock. Get a zoom in on Lefty's actually bleeding.
Oh my gosh.
Profusely.
It's not that punk rock. I picked a scab during the interview, and now it's bleeding profusely.
Well, medic, we'll get you something.
All good.
I know, Lefty, you in particular have a lot going on. I mean, there's day jobs and stuff, of course, too, but musically, I mean, you do your own stuff. You do the hoedown every year, which I know takes a lot of work.
Yeah.
You do this band, and I know you've been in like a million bands.
I've played in several bands. I've actually been cutting back, so that currently I'm only involved with 90 Pounds of Ugly, mm-hmm. and then sort of as a side project, my own band where I'm the singer.
Yeah.
But it's still Ernie and Steve playing bass and drums in the band, so it's the same lineup, but without Patsy,
right?
So she gets the night off. So those, you know, that's the other band. But like we play maybe twice a year. It's not my main band. 90 right. Pounds of Ugly is, but yeah, I played in a lot more. But I had to scale back because I was spreading myself too thin.
Yeah.
Whereas
that was my question. Like, how do you? Because I mean, you were in Polymorphines.
I was in
like
Polymorphines
and
for a couple years.
666.
I was in the 666 as well.
And so I mean, did you ever in that kind of period? Were you going home at night?
No, it wasn't that bad. Like most,
how does it work?
Most of these bands practiced once a week.
Yeah.
You know, and so, there was one point, I think, where I had three rehearsals a week,
right.
and on top of my radio show.
Right.
So that was really wearing me out, and that's kind of where I had to make the decision to start cutting back.
Yeah.
You know, but that said, it's not like other people can't do that. Steve and Ernie are in, I think, six other bands together.
Right.
Where they're a rhythm section or in some configuration,
yeah.
and they're practicing all week long, and they've got a lot of stuff going on.
Mm-hmm.
They've got time in their lives, and that's fantastic for them.
Yeah.
I wish I had time to be in 10 different bands,
yeah.
but I'm trying to focus really hard on songwriting.
Mm-hmm.
I don't do that enough of that anymore.
Right.
I write one song every 3 months right now. That's not a very good rate.
Right.
And I never practice guitar.
Mm-hmm.
My main instrument. I never play it anymore. I just pick it up to learn a new song and just go. So yeah, I'm trying to just kind of focus on just playing music right now.
Well, I've heard of the Ottawa curse. I mean, most, I think, smaller towns have this thing where if you're in a band, you play a lot within that town and people maybe at six seen you.
It's true. No, it's true.
Have you found that to be an issue with any of your acts or even with 90 Pounds? I know you guys don't gig a lot.
That's intentional, yeah. We try to limit it to about every 2 months we do a show.
Okay.
And it's partly a matter of wanting to draw out a crowd. It's also partly a matter of wanting to put a lot of energy into promoting a particular show.
Right.
If you play too often, you start to get sick and tired of, I got to go put up more posters.
Right.
I'm going to make another Facebook event. Oh, another press release. You know?
It turns into work, right?
So, exactly. It stops being fun. So if you spread the shows out, then each promotional campaign is kind of like a fun little go to try and get some word out.
Yeah.
And we've done a lot of different campaigns that really sort of popped. Like, for instance, we did one where we had a telephone number that you could call. And it would be just an answering machine message, and it was an answering machine message explaining what show we were about to have and when to come.
Oh, yeah.
And some people would leave messages, and we even left them all, like, we recorded the best ones and put them on our MySpace for some time. So we really care about, like, giving the public a reason to come out.
Right.
So that's why we put it in between, you know, our short periods of time. You know, we don't want to have us too swamped.
Yeah. Well, let's go back to this fine album available at 90poundsofugly.com. Is that correct?
Yeah, that is correct. Mm-hmm.
What was the story with this record in particular? I know it came out last year, but how did it all come together? Especially if you're writing, a song every few months, it must have taken a little while to put this thing together.
Well, I'm not the chief songwriter of the band. We all sort of, me, Liz, and Steve sort of share those duties somewhat equally. Not in equal numbers, mm-hmm. but equal force or strength. Mm-hmm. So we just kind of, we sort of spurt out songs whenever. So it was just, those were written periodically throughout the period after the first album was released. Right. We just sort of started sprinkling in new songs until we had enough to record this album.
Because all the while we are gigging and making sure that we're doing shows outside of town. Because we're going to Kingston, we're going to Hamilton, we're going to Toronto, shows outside and around. And that's how we made our money. That's how we self-released our albums.
Right.
Because we had to gig enough times to create this capital.
Yeah. So there was no, like some bands will head into the studio to write an album. Mm-hmm. You know, we didn't do that.
Yeah, no.
Ours was more just kind of bits and pieces over the span of about 3 years.
Yeah.
Even right up until the last minute, there's actually one song on this album that it's called Sunday Walk of Shame. We'd never played it live.
Yeah.
I wrote it. I taught it to Patsy. She learned to sing it. The chords, the music is very basic, so Ernie and Steve just kind of figured it out on the fly.
Right.
But Ernie, when we recorded the drum parts, Ernie'd never heard the song.
Oh, really?
He'd maybe heard like a demo of it somewhere, but he'd never played it. I said, Ernie, just play a really basic beat and I'll strum along.
Yeah.
And we recorded the drum parts. So that's how down to the wire it was. But I really wanted to put that song on the album because it's such a strong, sad ballad that it needed to be there. And I didn't think the album would have been complete without it.
And it wasn't until it was there.
Correct.
Nice. Well, how about we use that as a segue to another track? Can you play that one, or do you have another one in mind?
We're not going to play that one today. It doesn't really bode well for our acoustic setup. So
fair enough.
We're going to play...
I think we'll play Way Down.
Way Down.
I like that one.
It's a hellish sexy song.
Excellent. Let's get sexy with 90 Pounds of Ugly.
Sexy. Nice.
Let's get sexy. Your blood, it boils so hot. The lies you chase are subtle. Your time, my love of the night. The devil lives inside you. Yes, he's writhing in your skin. He sets out that longing fever. Yeah, he's stoking the fire within. My heart's got a black belt in sorrow. 86, your gap to grin. I'll be leaving your damn thing tomorrow. Stop losing myself in your sin. The devil lives inside you. Yes, he's writhing in your skin. He sets off that longing fever and he's stung fire within.
Nice.